We're also watching for what is starting to develop. This is a big dip in the upper atmosphere. Now, this is not associated with any colder air. What we are going to see, though, is a developing upper level low. This is going to create the instability. Basically, these colors, we call it atmospheric rotation. What we're looking at is instability in the atmosphere, where you would have that better chance for rain. And as that upper low forms, it is going to increase our rain chances for Saturday. Then as we get into Sunday, that upper low kind of elongates and weakens. This little spin right here, that's Ada trying to move into the Gulf. Now, what's interesting is here is all of the rotation, the energy with Ada moving into the Eastern Gulf. Now, we're going into now next Thursday, so a week from today, there it is in the Eastern Gulf. What starts to happen? It almost gets kind of ripped apart as the center tries to move northward, but the main energy gets ripped away. Why? Wind shear. This is not August, September, October. This is November, and the environment across the Gulf of Mexico is far more hostile at this time of year. Ada is still over land and just barely showing signs of any kind of circulation. The circulation is very broad. So first thing that has to happen, it has to get back out over open water. Second thing is it needs to start to get its act together. Now, the Hurricane Center thinks that may start to happen tomorrow, and Ada becomes a tropical storm, then continues toward Cuba. And the reason for this kind of sharp turn is we start to see some steering currents picking up and pushing the storm into the Gulf. The farther west the storm goes, the more likely it's going to encounter wind shear and dry air by next week. So even if it starts to move farther into the Gulf, maybe better for us because it has a higher likelihood of encountering some more of a hostile environment. Plus, water temperatures are much cooler. The model consensus has been over Cuba, making that turn kind of south of Florida or maybe into Florida and then into the Eastern Gulf. And notice this is going into Wednesday, Thursday, still not coming to southeast Louisiana. Now, that's not to say we may not at some point next week be placed once again under the cone of uncertainty, which if we were, that will be for the 8th time this season. This is the GFS, on top of which we have the forecast from the Hurricane Center. Basically in decent agreement, there's going to be a great deal of uncertainty with where it passes over Cuba, when it starts making that turn. Does it turn before moving over Florida or after the fact? If it moves over Florida, it has more time on land and we may see it weaken further. Point is, none of the models are indicating that this would be a powerful storm or actually right now, even a hurricane in the Gulf of Mexico. We will watch it.